Hi there. Welcome to the fourth video in the Datadog 101 series. Datadog 101 shows you everything you need to know to get the most out of the Datadog platform. I'm Matt Williams, and I'm one of the evangelists here at Datadog. This video covers functions, which enable you to surface the most relevant aspects of the data that you're collecting. You can use functions anywhere you see the query editor, such as with graphs, in a dashboard, and when defining monitors. Functions are available for an individual metric or in the advanced query expression. So let's create a new time board, add a time series graph, and start working with functions. To bring up the functions, click the plus icon to the right of the metric query. You can see the list is split into many groups, starting with arithmetic. The first function in arithmetic is the absolute value. Absolute can be useful if only the magnitude of the data value matters, and not the sign. Perhaps you have an application that runs best if it has 8 processes running, and you want to see how much it differs from that ideal. You could take the absolute value of 8, minus the number of processes to show the magnitude of the difference. Next on the list are the log functions, both log2 and log10. These will calculate the base2 and base10 logarithms of each value. When you have a graph that has a normal baseline with the occasional spike, the normal variations can be lost when the spike essentially resets the scale used in the graph. Using the log functions will bring the values closer together while not eliminating the spikes, which may happen with a smoothing algorithm. Cumulative sum and integral will add up the values shown in the span of a graph. Cumulative sum was designed to sum counters over a time frame, and integral does the same for rates. So let's say you have 2 buttons on a web page, and when either is clicked, they add a count metric. You could display a graph showing both and add the cumulative sum function to see how much more quickly one button reached a certain number of clicks versus the other within a given time span. The next section is interpolation, and each of the 4 options defines how we interpolate the values. Interpolation isn't about filling in all the missing values, but rather defining how missing values should be dealt with in a calculation with another metric. If there are 2 metrics I'm adding up, perhaps from different hosts, there's a good chance that the host collected the metrics at distinct times. When you display these calculated metrics, there may be unexpected negative spikes. To avoid this, you can use the interpolation function to fill in the blanks and ensure that the graph is more complete. The options for interpolation include using the last known value, filling it with 0, no interpolation, and using a linear function to fill in the missing values. For instance, if you're using that linear function, if the value before the missing one was 20 and the value after is 30, then the missing value will be interpolated to 25. You can also specify the fill limit. Setting this will limit how many seconds of data will be filled in. This will allow you to smooth over a few individual missing points without smoothing over a really big chunk of time that you might actually want to see. The next section is time shift. Time shifting allows you to display the current values alongside the corresponding values from an hour, a day, a week, or a month before. Next, there are 6 rate functions. First are per second, per minute, and per hour. Per second takes the difference of the current value from the previous value and divides that by the seconds in between each measurement. Per minute and per hour multiply those results by 60 and 3600 respectively. Time difference will show the number of seconds between the current and the previous values. Value difference shows the difference in value between the current and the previous values. And finally, the derivative divides the time difference by the value difference. Next comes smoothing, showing different configurations for moving average smoothing and median smoothing. Median smoothing looks at the last specified number of values, 3, 5, 7, or 9, calculates the median and displays that. The moving average algorithm used is also known as the exponentially weighted moving average. It calculates the average using the specified number of previous values, but the age of the values reduce the weight they receive in the calculation. Rollups come next. We collect data from the integrations on your host roughly every 15 seconds. If you have 1 day worth of data, that's about 5,760 data points. If you have 10 graphs on a dashboard, that would mean about 57,000 data points would have to be sent to your page, and that's a lot of data regardless of the speed of your connection. Also, many of the graphs are only 300 to 500 pixels wide, and it would be impossible to show 10 data points in a single pixel. As a result, we perform rollups automatically to limit the number of data points to 100 to 300 data points per graph. Depending on the time span in a graph, we may roll up the data into 5-minute bins when showing a day, to 2-hour rollups when showing a month. But let's say that you tend to look at one dashboard with a 1-hour time span. We'll roll up to 20-second bins on a line graph and 1-minute bins on a bar graph. If you want to see the data rolled up into 4-minute bins, then you can use the rollup function and specify a period of 240 seconds. Of course, if you zoom out to show 1 month, that would be about 10,000 data points, so we'll roll up to a larger interval automatically. When I choose rollup, I have the option to roll up the max values, the min values, averages, or the sums. After rollups is ranking, where you can opt to display the top or bottom X number of metric values. You can specify the metrics, the sort order, and the aggregation method, which is the attribute to sort by. Max, min, mean, and last are pretty self-explanatory, but you can also choose the L2 norm and the area aggregation methods. Next on the list are the count functions. These will count the number of values appearing in the graph at any given point. When displaying a single line, this will be either 1 or 0, depending on whether a value appears at that time. But if you specify a tag in the group by box, you'll see the number vary. If you choose to group by host, you'll see for any given time how many hosts reported values at that time. The choices are to count non-zero values or non-null values. Regression functions come next. Regressions allow you to visualize the trends of your metrics. Apply a trend line, and you'll see a line representing the ordinary least squares regression. A robust trend is similar, but doesn't react to brief anomalies and spikes, whereas the regular trend line will trend in the direction of the spike as soon as it occurs. Both trend line and robust trend will show a single line representing the trend of the entire graph. Using piecewise constant, we'll evaluate the trends on small constant value segments. Finally, there are the outlier and anomaly algorithms. Both look for strange behavior. Outlier detection looks for individual series of a group that are behaving differently than other group members, while anomaly detection looks for strange behavior in a given metric based on the metric's past performance. For outlier detection, there are 4 algorithms that can be used: MAD, scaled MAD, DBScan, and scaled DBScan. For anomaly detection, there are basic, agile, robust, and adaptive. We have a great blog post that goes into a lot of detail on this, so if you're interested, be sure to follow this link. We're often adding new ways to work with the data on Datadog, so don't be surprised if you see more functions on the list than what we've covered here. And while I've looked at each function on their own, you can combine most of them in interesting ways. For instance, you might want to show time-shifted differentials using a set of functions like this. And that brings us to the end of the functions video. We've gone through each of the functions, but now it's your turn to discover where they add value to your favorite graphs and dashboards. If you have any questions, please let us know. Thanks so much for watching. Goodbye.